What's up, gamers? Hey, once again, thanks again for tuning in to the Game of Rebirth DL channel. So what do we have today? Today we have an amazing video with the auto plugin. Now, this auto plugin has incorporated Therpy's USB to PC streaming from the PlayStation Vita, which is great. This is amazing. I think it is a dream come true. Now, these two tools will serve to stream our PlayStation Vita content to the PC. Now, the auto plugin just makes it easier for us to install it. So we will go to the developer's GitHub so that we can know a little bit more about what's going on with the USB streaming to the PlayStation Vita. This is from Serpy, which is pretty cool. I'll go ahead and leave the link in the description. Now, this is POC version 5 PS Vita USB streaming. The changes from the version 4 use main DRAM instead of CD-RAM for color space conversion output. Now, games have more CD-RAM available and chances are more of them will boot now. Properly handle frame buffers with size different than 960x544. Reduce plugin size, general code cleanups, and more information as well. Now you will need OBS, and I'll go ahead and leave that link in the description as well. You can download the SKPRX plugin directly from here, and then you can follow the path. But thanks to the auto plugin, we don't really need to do that unless you like to centralize your plugins like I do. So there's more information in regards to this article. You can go ahead and read it, but we'll go to the Heroes GAC GitHub and we will go ahead and get the auto plugin BPK, which it has incorporated the US Vita plugin streaming latest version. So this is pretty cool. I love it when our developers get together and create things that makes it easier for us. So go get that auto plugin BPK. So once we have our plugin BPK, then we will go ahead and get the OBS Studio, which is Open Broadcaster Software. Now I have Windows, so I'm going to select the Windows downloader. So then I'm going to download it. It might take a few moments. And then I'm going to run it in my PC. So I agree to the terms and conditions. I just go next and install. Okay, so now it'll open up. It'll give us a prompt. We select okay. Now we move on to the PlayStation Vita before we launch OBS. Now with the PlayStation Vita, we're going to install the auto plugin application or VPK. Now if you agree to the prompts, then just select yes. And of course I agree to these prompts. Now that this plugin makes our life amazing with PlayStation Vita, I don't know, for me right now, I think the PlayStation Vita, it's even better than the Switch. Sorry, Nintendo, but I love the PlayStation Vita and what it's capable of. So go get that auto plugin and then we run it. Okay, has a nice intro, and some of you already have this, but I've been wanting to do a video in this, and this is the perfect occasion, I think. So you have other options. Install plugin SD2 Vita, install plugins, install plugin non-PDRM. So we just select the install plugins, and then you will have all sorts of plugins. No AVLs, Bisilica Impina, Repatch, DS3 Vita, DS4 Vita, UDC underscore UVC by Serpy. Now that's the one for the USB. Adrenaline, download enabler, you know, anything you want. Just click of a button, it's here, it's amazing. Finally, I was able to do this video. Sorry guys for the delay, I've been so busy. So to install the plugin, we press X to erase the plugin. Then you can press select, but in this case, we're going to restart. We're gonna press start to close the application. Now this plugin needs the Vita to be restarted, so we'll go ahead and do that right now. So we press start. You can see it's Enzo. This should work for other PlayStation Vitas with Handcore as well. As long as you have the plugin installed, you should be fine. Okay, so we're back to our PlayStation Vita. Now we move on to the PC and we launch OBS. Now once you launch, it's going to give you some prompts. Just press OK and then OK. If it tells you the wizard, just say no. You can always go back and do the wizard, but we don't really need it. So you can go to view and it'll give you more options in regards to this application. You can enable full screen interface if you want, which is pretty cool. This is a new tool, simple to use. So go get the tool. You will need it now from now on to stream your games to your PC. If you right click, it gives you more options as well. As you guys can see. So now let's go ahead and get to the cool stuff. So you can go to settings and also change more options like the audio and the video. Now I'm just going to change the frame skip to 60. So I like to have it crisp. Okay, so now in order to capture our PlayStation Vita, we go to the little plus sign and then we're going to video capture device. Now keep in mind that the PlayStation Vita currently is plugged into the PC via USB. So under sources, here we're going to add a profile and I'm going to call it PS Vita. You guys can see it's capturing my lock screen. I haven't even opened my PlayStation Vita. Now it gives you more options on what you can select, which is pretty cool. Now we select OK. Okay, awesome. Now you can resize it. It just depends how you're going to stream it. You can probably even live stream. You guys can see it's working. Everything's going fine with the PlayStation Vita. Now here, supposedly you can change the audio output either to the PC only and or just to the PlayStation Vita. So I was trying to play with it. Unfortunately, I couldn't get it to work, but if you guys get it to work, leave a comment. It will help us all. Now to detach the screen, let's say if you wanted to do, I don't know, different view, then you would select window projector preview. You will get like a little different window, which is pretty cool. You can keep it on the side. I don't know if you're doing a tutorial like Gamer Rebirth, then you can keep it on the side. Or let's say that you wanted to do more windows, then you can do an additional window. You can have dual screen. Maybe you have two monitors and you're playing against your friend on the other side. Now with the Flows plugins, Vita TV. So if you have a different monitor, you can guys have a rematch or a versus match. So now the previous plugin was having trouble with Adrenaline. I just wanted to launch it. You guys can see that Adrenaline, it's working, it's launching. Now I'm going to select the game. Okay, so I will select Metal Slug. Now I think this is a PlayStation 1 game. So if you see it kind of slow, it is not the projection of the PlayStation Vita to the PC. It is the actual game. So now, here is the actual footage for the PlayStation Vita. You guys can see it is perfectly working. I didn't see no lag, nothing compared to the PlayStation Vita or the PC. Okay, so now I am going to go and select another game. Okay, so now if you guys see that is fast forwarding, it's because I did it in the video, but in the actual gameplay you will see that it's working fine. So here it is the actual game capture. Okay, you guys can see that it's working fine, it's synced. So now you can have your games in here. So guys, you can guys go ahead and stream your games to your PC, which is amazing. You know, big thumbs up for Serpy, the hero, for the auto plugin and all the developers that worked on it as well. all the plugins, everything that is making the PlayStation Vita an amazing console. So go and get the auto plugin. So guys, if this helped, remember to hit like, subscribe, share with your friends. As always, Gamer Rebirth out.